In War of the Tanks, survival is just about as much the enemy as you. That makes sense. Now, obviously, whether an enemy is firing premium or non-premium is going to be the main factor there. However, a nuance that doesn't get appreciated is the expectations of the enemy. For example, say you're attempting a damage blocked mission in a heavy tank. I would never recommend that you do that in a holdown IS-7. Yes, you'll be immortal, yes, no one can pin you, but no one will shoot at you. Because I know that they won't succeed. And that's what we're focusing on today, some specific tank moves and general gameplay stuff that is based on realistic game scenarios as opposed to just on paper values. So let's begin with what's probably a quite unexpected nation, the French. Now, the French, at least prior to the introduction of the second heavy branch, had this reputation of having quite poor armor across the board, right? Why is this relevant? Well, rules such as French tanks have bad armor get generalized fairly easily in the minds of many a player. And we can very easily take advantage of that. So let's get ourselves in an AMX M449, the Liberté. Now, an interesting quirk about this vehicle is that when it's flat onto you, the lower plate has quite a bit better armor than the upper plate. So what do? You go up to a corner and stick your lower plate around it. Now, if you ever wanted an easy mode for completing Coalition 5 for the Object 279E, the AMX M449 is your baby. Because everyone and their mother will happily unload metric butt-tons of ineffective ammo into the lower plate of this vehicle. But let's say you can't get the AMX M449, it's a premium tank after all. Fear not, if you can acquire an AMX 50B, the tier 10 tech tree heavy tank or one of them, not a lot of people are aware the AMX 50B has some of the best frontal hull armor on any heavy tank in the entire game. And so, when you want to go and unload on something in the 50B, try the same thing. Stick your frontal armor just around the corner. I guarantee you, 90% of players will take that shot. They won't pin it though. Or perhaps some smart ass will shoot at the upper portion of this armor. Well, it's still anywhere from 290 to 330, so have fun with that. What people will and won't shoot at is integral to learn in heavy tank gameplay if you're looking to master it, because the purpose of bouncing shells, other than to mitigate losing hit points, is often to open opportunities to return fire. Right, this is especially relevant in tanks like a Mouse C100 KV4, where the proper angling of the tank demands that you actually turn the gun away from the enemy. Now let's take a tank that anyone will shoot at, the IS-4. Now the IS-4 is a good tank against bad players. Now tanks fall out of favour as metas change and players adapt. Those tanks that can't keep up, they get left behind. But there's blessings in rarity, because the less common a tank is, the less players know how to combat it. It's why I liked the STI over the E75. It's why the old Object 263 was so deadly. When you have an out of meta tank with one incredibly defining characteristic, the enemy's lack of knowledge becomes your single greatest asset. 160mm of side armor. One of the very few tanks in the game that you can correctly angle at 40 degrees or more. The IS-4 is bait. 90% of your gameplay is letting the enemy shoot when they think they have a pending shot, but they don't. So what do? Well, you over-angle the side, and then you go, "Hark, I hath exposed my side armor. This is the worst." And then you laugh. Of course, if they're a good player and firing heat, they'll always have a pending shot, no matter what, all the time. is a good tank against bad players. To sum up that last point I just made, basically amounted to play the IS-4 well. You're welcome. The Super Conqueror is one of, if not the most popular tier 10 heavy in the entire game. I mean, let's face it, this entire line should be called Why You Don't See American Heavy Tanks Anymore. But anyone who has a Super Conqueror will probably have at some point experienced the tier 5, the tier 6, and the tier 7. These are not good tanks. They're slow, they're inflexible, rapid-fire guns that have a few redeeming qualities. However, one thing that they all have in common is they have tracks that significantly extend past the front of the hull. Meaning, if you stuff your drag wheel around a corner, yes, the enemy can track you, but they can't actually do any damage. I don't care what's shooting at you, okay? It's not gonna... Okay, well, it's highly unlikely you're going to get shot on by a Death Star in a Churchill 1. You take my point. Sticking your track around a corner can be useful in a variety of ways. You can absorb a shell if you've got an enemy with a long reload, or you can just let the enemy keep taking that shot and waste their time, which can be more useful than it sounds if, for example, your team is winning the other side. If you want to delay the enemy, give them that shot. So I had to re-record this bit because I realized while editing that I'm bad. We're going to talk about actually angling your tank. And I don't mean just left and right, blah, blah, blah. I mean physically tilting your tank to enhance the armor in very popular weak spots. Let's take an E-100 for example, where you've got 200mm of armor on the upper plate and 150 on the lower plate. And that's a 50mm nominal difference between the two surfaces. Now, what will happen when you tilt a tank backwards, as in you reverse the rear of the tank up something behind you, be it a wall, be it a broken down structure, whatever it may be, right? The upper plate, as you can see demonstrated by this lovely guitar book here, the upper plate is going to go like this. Now, as you can see, the upper plate is now taking up more of your view than it was when it was tilted like this. It has become a more presentable target. Now, it's still 200mm thick. It's still more effectively thick than the lower plate will be because it's that much thicker, right? So you reverse up a wall, your upper plate is gonna go like this, it's gonna become a more presentable target. Meanwhile, your lower plate down here, which could be penned, is gonna go like this. Not only is it gonna become a smaller target, but the enhanced angle on it will actually probably mean that you can finally bounce those shells that your lower plate on tanks like an E-100, an E-75, a mouse, was only about 5-10 degrees away from bouncing to begin with. There are certain tanks in the game, take an IS-7 for example, that will really highly benefit from angling the upper plate a little bit forward, weakening the upper plate a little bit, but strengthening the lower plate because people will be aiming at it. And with that extra angle, yes, you can bounce shells that you'd never bounce if you angled regularly. So be aware of how and where you can tilt your tank if you know that someone shooting at you is going to be able to pin your weak spots normally. Now, pressing the 2 key seems to be everyone's recourse for a heavily armored tank these days. The wargaming don't seem to gather that you can't balance armor for standard and premium ammo with penetration holes almost 100mm apart. A fact I took the piss out of in my World of Tanks Abridged video.
Yeah! I'm an E5! America!
But I angle.
Pow!
Denied!
Yeah, what now, you fat German son of a-
However, heat shells, and indeed any kind of high explosive shell in World of Tanks, do very, very poorly against spaced armor. Now, what is spaced armor? Spaced armor is tracks, spaced armor is guns, spaced armor is fucking Sheridan! If a HEP shell hits spaced armor, it is highly likely to just explode on the armor, resulting in a non penetrating shot. So in certain situations, when you see it using the info panel that you should have enabled in settings, but the enemy is firing a high explosive ammunition type, you control them hard by over-angling. This works in any vehicle. Here I'm about to be set upon by a KV-2. Now the KV-2 has 910 alpha damage and 86mm of pen with HE. That's more than enough to pen a 9x1357. But I turn sideways, thereby increasing the chance of him hitting my tracks. Understanding that tracks and other forms of spaced armor perform very, very well against high explosive shells is a very nice thing to have in your ass. Guns. Tanks have guns. Guns which, as hilarious as it would be, do not have collision models in the game. They do, however, have hitboxes, meaning they can and will be shot, damaged, and destroyed by enemy shells. If you understand this, you can utilize it to your advantage. For example, when in a situation where an enemy tank is aiming for your cupola, you can use the physical hitbox of your gun to block the shell, or at least give them a much harder shot. This is especially effective when dealing with high explosive ammo. For example, we recently had a KV-2 tourney in team training on stream. I was left on a one shot against JDEG, who would beat my reload. So I stuck my gun barrel directly down his, and when he fired, his shell hit the barrel of my gun and took him with me. I did the same thing to this T-49 in a random battle. Now obviously in an ideal world, you do this without blowing up, right? Or you do it to Artie. Okay, come on Ian, you got this. You've got to get him to kill himself. You've got to do it. You can.
Reverse.
Let him push you up the hill. Then your gun will be high enough, and you can get him to kill himself.
No, he's not pushing me.
Oh, yeah, that worked! Okay, I've done the gun! Left, Ian, left! Oh, come on. Up a little bit. Yeah, come on! Come on, Ian! Come on! Believe in yourself! He's wiggling! Yeah! It was worth the plight!
Jesus Christ.
Ian. Good work, my man. That's good stuff, man. 10 out of feckin' 10. Because that never gets old. I'll take a moment now to suggest if you'd like to learn more about this kind of thing, there's a Learn What the Tanks playlist up and out there, and if it piques your curiosity, I recently released a video covering a glitch that enabled us to send tanks to space. Which was fun. That's also up here and in the description. Finally, if you have an Object 279E, then you already know all this shit. Bye.